Hello students, good to see you in the series of e-learning program. Once again today, I'm back here to teach you with a continuation of lecture, that is the topic about collective nouns and abstract nouns, of which we understood about the collective nouns, practiced two of the exercises. We also initiated the basic understanding of the abstract nouns, which we are going to continue in this lecture. Abstract nouns is the name of a quality, an action, or a state for which I had placed a number of examples, word examples on the board in the previous lecture. Words like kindness, goodness, honesty, wisdom, bravery, politeness, and truth referred to as quality, which is an abstract noun. If I refer to action as an abstract noun, words like laughter, hatred, movement, theft, judgment, and many more could be added to this list are all action form of abstract nouns. Words which are abstract nouns and fall in the group of as a state, the words like childhood, boyhood, manhood, slavery, youth, freedom, sickness, poverty, and death. Well, the words that I just spoke out as a state are called abstract nouns. Well, our topic of discussion for today will be focused on the construction or the formation of these abstract nouns. We also learned in the previous lecture some names of arts and sciences. I hope you remember the word chemistry. So today we are going to learn about the formation of abstract nouns from different words like adjectives, verbs, and common nouns. So let's move along with the first thing, that is the formation of abstract nouns from a few adjectives. Formation of abstract nouns from adjectives, verbs, and common nouns. Let's take a few adjectives from which we can derive, from which we can make or form an abstract noun. Let's take quickly a few examples. Words like form, abstract, from, adjectives. Taking a word, goodness, to form its adjective from an abstract noun, from a given adjective, we can write the word by eliminating the word goodness, the ness from the goodness word, and deriving the word, or we can say taking the extract out of it and write the word good. Because good is the word which describes a noun, therefore it becomes an abstract noun. Good, something which is good, you can understand, you can feel, but it is not a physical thing that can be shown to someone. So goodness is the adjective, whereas the word good is its abstract noun. And vice versa, if you have been given the word good and you've been asked to form an adjective out of it, the vice versa, good plusness becomes goodness. Similarly, the word bravery, from the word brave, so you see, form abstract from the given adjectives. Bravery, brave. Honesty, from the word honest, So the words like goodness, bravery, honesty will be our words. Taking the abstract noun which are formed from the verbs, let's take a few examples from verbs. From verbs, taking the words obedience, obedience, obedience from the verb obey, obey, which is a verb, and the word, the abstract noun formed out of the word obey is obedient, just as the word good, brave, honest were adjectives and we formed the abstract nouns from them as goodness, bravery and honesty, which can't be shown to someone as a non-physical component. Similarly, obedience, yes, I obey my parents, I obey my obey to my teachers, but can you show the physical thing obedience if asked you to show? No, that's practically impossible. It can be felt when you've been given instructions and you obey them, okay, you follow them. So you are showing your obedience towards your parents and teachers, hence the quality vested inside your deeds, your actions speak for you, that is obedience. Hence the word obedience is an abstract noun formed from the verb obey. Pleasure, another word, similar one, from word please, the word please, pleasure, please. Please is a word, a verb, and we say the word formed out of it is pleasure. Similarly, the word punishment is a word formed out of the word punish. Okay, punish, an action doing word. And the word punishment is something, okay, I got punishment today. Can you show the punishment to me? No. Practically or physically, the word punishment cannot be proved or shown to someone. It's a non-physical existing word that cannot be shown to anyone. Therefore, punishment is the abstract noun derived from the verb punish. Well, going along with the formation of abstract nouns from common nouns, words like common nouns, the abstract nouns formed are childhood, a state, as we discussed in the types or the subtypes of abstract nouns as quality, action and state. So a state of being in which someone stays for a certain period of time, childhood, from the word child, which is a common noun. We learned in the types of noun, proper, common, with child is a common noun. So childhood is something that cannot be shown as a physical element to someone, but obviously one can feel, one can think about it. So childhood, from the common noun child. Word slavery or the abstract noun slavery, from the word slave, or slave is a common noun and slavery is an abstract noun. Now one of the purpose of learning this is that when you go to the higher classes in the board examinations, there is a section in grammar where you are asked to transform or change words from its, or to form abstract nouns. That time you will find this learning in class 8 very useful in class 10. So pay proper attention when you're learning this. The word kingdom. Kingdom. From the word king is an abstract noun. kingdom, king. So here we have been able to write a few words that are abstract nouns derived or formed from the adjectives, verbs and common nouns. I hope this is going to help you a lot with the understanding of creating abstract nouns. Now, one important thing to note that since abstract nouns are uncountable, you can't count them. Whatever abstract noun you see, bravery, goodness, honesty, childhood, can you count them as 1, 2, 3, 4? No, you cannot count them. Counting is not possible. Okay, therefore we can say one thing very sure about abstract nouns, that as they are uncountables, you cannot form its plural. Since abstract nouns are uncountables, their plurals cannot be formed. Their plurals cannot be formed. So you do not have any plurals for any of these abstract nouns. You can't say goodnesses or braveries or honesties or obediences. No, can't be said. There is no such word existing. It does not exist at all in English. Well, hopes, charity, charities, love, loves, kindness, kindnesses, nothing of such sort can be done. So there is no plural for an abstract noun. Moving ahead, we'll see a number of words for a practice of all these three kinds for our better understanding and to become experts in creating, and which will also help you to learn and explore new words and add to your word bank as we did in the previous lecture. So let's form abstract nouns from adjectives for the following words that I display on the board. Moving ahead, form abstract nouns from the following adjectives. Let's see a few words. Words like adventurous, and we will write the word for that is adventure. Adventure. So you see, similarly, we'll write a couple of words which will increase our knowledge about formation of adjectives, abstract nouns from adjectives. Anxious. Could you guess the word? Probably the word is anxiety. And you pronounce it as anxiety. Yes, it's pronounced as anxiety. The third word, which is an adjective, energetic. And we write or form the abstract energy. The fourth word that you see, that you will be writing, is confident. And the answer is confidence, C-O-N-F-I-D-E-N-C, merely a change of a spelling and you get the abstract formed from the given adjective. Confident, you say, it is an adjective, whereas the word confidence, you say, it is a abstract noun. So make sure when you speak these words or write these words or you communicated these words, be very careful in using them. Confidence. Confidence is the abstract noun formed from the adjective confident. The fifth word, able. The word is ability. Ability. The sixth word I pronounce it as chaotic. Chaotic. And I say, or I pronounce the abstract noun as chaos. C-H-A-O-S. Chaos. The pronunciation of K is used and not chaos, but chaos. We don't say chaotic or chaos. We say chaotic and chaos. So be careful with the pronunciation of these two words, of which chaotic is an adjective and chaos is the abstract noun derived or formed from it. The seventh word is compassionate. Compassionate. To show concern for someone, compassion is the abstract noun formed from the word compassionate. So you eliminate the word ate. So you eat the word it. Okay, let me put it that way. Compassion. So from the word compassionate, if you cut out the it and eat the it, well, I don't want you to eat the it. It's just a way of saying compassionate. You eat up the it and you say compassion. So that is how you remember how to form the word compassion out of the word compassionate. That will help you to remember these things. When you use such little tricks and techniques, some words will be very easy for you to remember. Just as in the word number 8, content, the answer to this one is nothing else but the same word itself, content. But the thing is, the pronunciation changes over here. Content and content. Content and content. Determined is the next word, which is an adjective. Determined. Determination becomes my abstract noun created out of the word determined. And the next word, number 10, deceitful. Deceitful. And I make a word which is an abstract out of it. Deceit. D-E-C-E-I-T. Deceit. Which is the abstract noun derived or extracted from the word deceitful by eliminating the words ful, and I get my required word, that is a abstract noun. The next word, democratic. Yes, surely you must have heard this word learning in social science, democratic, and the abstract noun that is non-physical, can't be seen. We as in India are a democratic country and we follow democracy in our country. So the word is democracy. Democracy refers to the abstract noun derived from the word democratic. Likewise, the 12th word, curious. Curious. Yes? I think you must have guessed the answer by now. Most of you must have guessed it. Quite sure. Curious, curiosity. Adding the ity, change it into curiosity. Curious is the adjective and curiosity has been formed as its abstract noun. Curiosity. Well, these were 12 words which were adjectives transformed or formed into its abstract noun. Going further, we have a couple of more words which needs to be changed into its abstract noun, but they are going to be changed from their verb form. Verbs changed into abstract noun. Well, the understanding of all this is very important because most of the time in the board examinations you have a set of words like this where you have to change the given word into its abstract form or adjective form, whatever the question is asked. Therefore, the knowledge of this is quite important in the early ages of learning. In class 8, if you start learning these things, by class 10, it helps you a lot. Well, let's practice one more set of words where you're going to change the given verbs into its abstract noun. Let's see some. Form abstract nouns from the following verbs. Let me change this into verbs. We remember that we are working with verbs. The verbs. Okay. Going ahead. The first one, we already put our hands on this earlier when we were discussing about the examples. Obedience, obey. So you should be knowing it now. The word is obey, which is a verb, and we are about to write its abstract noun. Obedience. O-B-E-D-I-E-N-C-E. Obedience is the abstract noun of obey. The word die, D-I-E, die, and the abstract noun for this is nothing else but death. You are absolutely right if you got that right. The third one, an action doing word, verb, laugh, and you change it into laughter. We just discussed this word too, I believe so. Laughter into, laugh into laughter. So laughter is the abstract noun derived from the word laugh. And laughter is something that you cannot physically show to anyone. So it's an abstract noun. A word, marry, and you write the abstract noun of this word as marriage. Okay? Think a little bit about this word. Marriage. It cannot be shown. It's not a physical element, something that can be shown, but it only can be understood well. Moving ahead to the next word, advice. Advice. Think about this word, advice. How could it be changed into its abstract? Pretty simple. Advice, and when I write the abstract, again I am going to pronounce the same word advice, but there is a change in its spelling. Advice, SE, is a verb, whereas the word advice is its abstract noun. Many a times this word is misused in sentences. Okay, I gave him an advice, and you write advice. That tends to become wrong. You gave him an advice, something that you gave him. It's a noun, an abstract noun. So you ought to write advice and not advice in your sentence. So advice is the verb, whereas advice is the abstract noun. It's just a matter of difference in spelling. You change the spelling and a verb becomes into an abstract noun, and vice versa. The next word, fail. And to create its form, its abstract noun, we just add ure and make it failure. F-A-I-L-U-R-E, failure. So the word failure is the abstract noun. Moving ahead, the next word, no. And I'm not saying N-O, no. I am saying K-N-O-W, no. K-N-O-W, no. And I believe you must have framed the answer by now very quickly. K-N-O-W-L-E-D-G-E, knowledge. Knowledge is the abstract noun of the verb no. Okay? No is a verb, and so knowledge is its abstract noun. If I ask you, can you show me your knowledge? No. You say your knowledge is in your brains, in your heads. You will be able to point out to your head. But the thing that is non-physical as a phenomenal thing, it's inside, it's vested inside your brains. At the most, you will be able to dig out your brain and show it to me. But still, you will not be able to show me the knowledge that lies within your brain. It is a non-physical thing that can only be understood, felt, but you cannot touch it. So knowledge is the abstract noun of the word no. The eighth word, depart, the action of leaving and going. Okay, we depart from our beloved ones when you're going or traveling from one place to another, a verb. Now, to make its abstract noun, we have to add the word ure once again to it by making it departure. Departure is the abstract noun. Departure cannot be seen. You may see a person bidding farewell and going away from you, but that phenomenal thing or the thing that happening is called departure, leaving from one place and going. That would, the thing that you experience, okay, is the departure. But physical thing cannot be seen. Number 9. Word is believe. Believe. And the abstract noun for that is belief. You change the VE into IE, and then you drop out the word VE and you write the word FE. When you must be learning about singulars and plurals, you must have laid your hands onto this word belief, believe. Okay, you change it to believe. So here the word belief is the abstract noun for the word believe. The 10th one, hate. Yet another feeling, yet another quality, a word that states quality vested inside the humans. Hate, you do not like someone. Hate, and to make the abstract out of it, we need to just make a little change in the word and write hatred, where the letter E needs to be dropped out and the spelling of the color red is to be added. Hatred. So the desired word is created, hatred. The 11th word I will be writing as pursue. P-U-R-S-U-E. Pursue. Let me discuss the word pursue. Pursue means to gain something. Right now you are pursuing knowledge. Okay, you are gaining knowledge. So when you pursue something, when you gain something, you use the word pursue. So pursue, and the abstract noun for that will be pursuit. P-U-R-S-U-I-T. P-U-R-S-U-I-T. Pursuit. Yes, the suit that you wear, same spelling, the same pronunciation. Pursuit and pursue. So pursue is the verb, pursuit is the abstract noun. Taking ourselves even further and continuing with the acknowledgement of a number of words like this, which we are going to explore, discover and embed it into our word bank. The word destroy, yet another common word which is used in conversation, communication, destroy. And by now you must have created or formed the word for yourself. Most of you must be right, perhaps all of you must be right. Destruction, yes, the word destruction is the abstract noun for the word destroy, which is an action doing word verb, whereas destruction is the abstract noun formed from the word destroy. Moving ahead, the next word, the word is succeed. Succeed, and the abstract noun is nothing else but success. Succeed, success. Success is something, if you have been asked to show, well, you succeeded, show me your success. If I ask you a question, it's quite natural you can't show me your success. Yes, you must have got a reward, you must have been awarded for that, you must have been getting a cash prize, something, but or something you must have achieved. But your success can only be felt, can be experienced. It cannot be practically or physically shown as an element or a component to someone. Therefore, succeed is the verb and success is its abstract noun. The 14th word, think. Yes, the action of thinking. Right now you are thinking about the abstract noun, so the process going on in your brain is the process of thinking. So you all are thinking. So think about the abstract noun of the word think. So I'm asking you to think. So once you've thought about that, you will display it to me, you will tell it to me. So think, and the word is thought. Yes, we just revealed the word thought. Thought is something that is in your brain, in your mind, but I am sure you cannot show it to me as a practical thing, as a physical component or something. Okay, you may be able to say, sir, the thought is in my mind. Well, but can you show it to me? No, I can just feel or I can just experience when you speak it out, when you give the idea to me. So thought is the abstract noun. Think is the verb, thought is the abstract noun. Moving on with some more words. The 15th word is choose. Yes, you all choose things, isn't it? When given a chance, you choose things. When you go to buy something, choose. But when you've done that work of choosing, you have made a choice. Therefore, the word choice states an abstract noun. It's an action abstract noun. Choose and the word choice. When you have finished choosing, then you say, it's my choice. Now, can you show the choice to someone? Yes, you may see. Have a look at this t-shirt. Have a look at this gadget or something. I made a choice. Yes, you definitely made a choice. But the choice you are showing is the component or the object. You are not showing that choice to someone. Choice cannot be shown. It can be felt that out of the 2, 3, 4, 5 options given to you, you made one choice. Therefore, the word choice is an abstract noun. Moving further with the next word, serve. S-E-R-V-E, serve. S-E-R-V-E, serve. You serve someone. You give your, recall the word, or I should just say the word. Serve is the action word. And you give service to someone. Okay, you're serving, doing the action. But someone who is getting that thing from you is called as service. Now you don't, you can just experience that you're getting the service, but you can't show that word to anyone or show it as a component to anyone. Therefore, the word is service. Service is the abstract noun derived or made from the word serve, which is an action doing word. The 17th word, flatter. I hope you know the meaning of the word flatter. In case you don't, let me tell you. Flatter is to say good things about someone, whether really he deserves it or not. So, to keep on praising someone necessarily or unnecessarily, we say flatter. So, someone who is being flattered with the praiseworthy words, can we say flattery? So, here the word we have derived is flattery. Flattery is the abstract noun for the action word flatter. The next word, the action of revising something, learning again as we are doing in this chapter, in this topic, revise, to learn again, to recall the old knowledge again. So we do what? We are doing revision. As I told you, this chapter is a revision chapter in our text. Revise, the action doing word, and the abstract noun is revision. Very clear? So the word revision is nothing but an abstract noun derived from the word revise. More words to go about changing abstract nouns from words or forming abstract nouns from verbs. The word is grieve, G-R-I-E-V-E, grieve. To express sorrow, grieve. To cry, to become sad. So grieve, that's the meaning. So, when you grieve, you have that feeling inside, in your heart, your mind, which you cannot show. The only thing is, when you grieve, is either you shed tears, you have a gloomy face. These are certain signals or expressions that you bring on your face so that people know that you are sad, you are sorrow. But something that is vested inside you, contained inside you, is called grief, G-R-I-E-F, grief. So, The abstract noun for grieve is grief, G-R-I-E-F, grief. Grieve is the verb, grief is the abstract noun. Finally, before we are done with the formation of abstract noun from verbs, the last word is live. The action of living, what are we living? Yes, life. Therefore, life is something that cannot be shown. Yes, you can see I am alive. Yes, you are alive, but you have that thing which cannot be expressed as a physical matter to someone or shown to someone. That is life. Life is that virtual thing vested inside you, contained inside you. That is life. So live is the, and the word life is the abstract noun that is created from the verb live. Well, proceeding with a similar set of abstract nouns formed from common nouns. Okay, let's look into this. Finally, form abstract nouns from the following common nouns. Form abstract nouns from the following common nouns. I'll change the word verbs into common nouns and we will continue with our practice of framing or forming abstract nouns from the given common nouns. Let's practice together. Common nouns. The first one. The common word, king. Yes, a very common word. We already understood about this word in the example when you were learning. This is kingdom. Kingdom. A very common word, kingdom. Kingdom is the abstract noun formed from the common noun king. And there are going to be many more such words coming up. So very quickly we'll go with it. The word friend, a very common noun, friend. And the answer would be very easy for you, friendship. Very clear. Common nouns are very easy to be transformed into its abstract. Thief, yet another common noun, thief. And we create the abstract by changing it into thievery, T-H-I-V-E-R-Y, thievery. The word partner. Yes, and the answer will be partnership. Can you see the partnership between two or more people when they start a business? You may say, yes sir, have a look, they have a partnership, they are people. But the mutual understanding that they have between them, what we refer to as partnership in sharing the profits and bearing the losses. So partnership is the abstract noun formed from common noun partner. The fifth one, priest. And we say priesthood, just like for the word father and mother, we say fatherhood and motherhood, childhood. The same way, priest, priesthood. The quality vested in the priest. Another common word that we come across, agent. Yes, agent is the person or a common noun. We refer to a person who is handling an agency. So agency is the abstract noun derived from the word agent. Agency. The seventh word, captain. Very easy for you people. Captaincy. Okay, just the addition of the letter CY changes the word captain into captaincy, where captain is common noun and the word captaincy is the abstract noun created, formed from it. The word, a very common word, boy. So we have boyhood. And the word pilgrim, someone who goes on a holy tour. Pilgrim. Pilgrimage is the abstract noun, the actions that a person performs during his holy acts. Pilgrimage. The tenth word, enemy. You may be able to see a person and consider him to be your enemy, but the hatred that he has towards you, or the enmity that he has towards you or you have against him, cannot be seen. Therefore, the abstract noun is enmity, formed out of the common noun enemy. 11th word, dacoit. Do you know what is a dacoit? Someone who loots people during the daytime is called a dacoit. So when a dacoit does the action of looting, we say dacoitee. Dacoitee. So dacoitee is the abstract noun framed or formed from the word dacoit. The 12th word, state. And we just say statehood and nothing else. State, statehood. An easy word. Infant, a small baby, perhaps 0 to 1 month old. Infant, and the littleness or the little time, 0 to 1 month, what you call the time period is called infancy. The very small or the very young early age of that newborn child or newborn is called infancy. Okay, you may say, sir, we can see, you can see the person, the infant you can see, but the infancy that he is living upon cannot be seen as a physical matter or content. It can only be felt. Okay, so infancy is the abstract of infant. The 14th and perhaps the last one, where we are going to change a verb into its abstract. The word is bond, not James Bond, bond. Okay, joint or the bond, and we say bondage. The connection between someone, how strong it is. So the word is bondage, which is an abstract noun framed or formed from the word bond. Well, I will just quickly discuss a few antonyms of the abstract nouns with you before we close with this lecture and the topic as well. Let me take up a few antonyms of abstract nouns. Antonym means the opposite words for the given abstract nouns. Just the last thing to learn in this topic about abstract nouns, the antonyms formed from the abstract nouns. give antonyms or write antonyms. Antonyms of the abstract nouns given to you. Of abstract nouns. Okay, give antonyms of the abstract noun. The first one, G-U-I-L-T, guilt, yes? The feeling having done something wrong, or guilt, you are guilty conscious, having done wrong. So the opposite of guilt is nothing but the word innocence. You are innocent and innocence. I-N-N-O-C-E-N-C-E. Innocence. Innocence is the abstract, the antonym of guilt, which is an abstract noun. So we are writing the abstract noun, which is the opposite of the word given to us over here. The word love and its opposite abstract noun will be hate. Love, hate, weakness, and we are writing its antonym as strength. Weakness and strength. The next word in continuation is ignorance. Ignorance, not having knowledge about something, being unaware. So I just gave you a clue. Ignorance, that is being unaware of something. Just the opposite of that, awareness. You are ignorant, you have ignorance with you, you have awareness with you. Awareness and ignorance. So awareness is the antonym or the opposite of ignorance, meaning knowing, not knowing something. Scarcity. Scarcity is, or the word scarcity means having less of it or nothing of it or having shortage of it. Particularly the word shortage of something. We have scarcity of water in all parts of our country. But if I say we have lots and lots of that, I will have to use the word abundance. Maybe it's a new word for you, so just learn it. Abundance. That is quite a lot, too much. Abundance. A-B-U-N-D-A-N-C-E. Abundance is the antonym of scarcity and vice versa. Sixth word, freedom. And the antonym will be slavery. So we are just trying to learn, acknowledge ourselves with set of abstract nouns which are the antonyms of each other. The seventh one, bravery. Okay, bravery. Think a little about, take a moment before I put it on the board. Probably some of you must have got it. I believe not all. Okay, let me put up the word which is the antonym of bravery. Still thinking? Okay. The word is cowardice. You know, you're a coward. Okay? You are a coward, and the word becomes cowardice, which is vested, a quality vested in someone. Someone who is not brave, who runs away from the situation, is not able to handle the situation. So you say he's a coward, and he has cowardice within him. So bravery, cowardice. The next word, modesty. modesty. Someone who is very polite, down to earth, we say he possesses modesty within him. But there would be people who are just opposite to modesty. Can you think of a word which is the antonym of modesty? 10 seconds. Okay, maybe you know about it. Just check it out when I write it. Someone who is very polite and does not have an arrogant nature. So the word is arrogance. Yes, the word is arrogance. Probably, if you do not know, it's an addition to your knowledge. Modesty, polite, calm. Arrogance, someone who is against something. A violent nature, so arrogance. Well, the next one should be very simple for you, in case you can make it up. The word is wealth. Lot of riches. Wealth. Can you just find the opposite abstract noun for wealth? Probably yes. Then very good. I'll put it up on the board. It is poverty. Poverty. Okay. Moving ahead with the next one. The word is reward. Reward, and we need the opposite word. When you do a good thing, you are felicitated, you are praised for it, with a reward given to you. What is the opposite of reward? You get punishment. So you are punished. Reward, and you get punishment. Okay? Reward, punishment. The next word, health. Health, you are good, you have got no disease, no illness with you, then you say you are health, you've got health, or you are hale and hearty. So health, the opposite of that is sickness. When you are sick, sickness, the antonym of health. I have good health. The word good is used with the word health to describe it as an adjective. Yes, now the last word, victory, success. Just as we word the word succeed, success. Victory. So victory will be, yes, you must have been able to find out. Victory, defeat. When you lose someone, something against someone, you have your defeat. D-E-F-E-A-T, defeat. So victory, defeat. So with this, we've had a lot of understanding and practice too about the formation of abstract nouns from adjectives, verbs, and common nouns. In addition to that, we learnt about the antonyms for a few abstract nouns that are displayed on the board. Well, I hope you learnt quite a lot of things, and you will be able to do something more and do the homework given to you. Well, good luck. Till then, goodbye and see you soon.